Debts paid by the Marcos administration jumped year on year in May due to a surge in interest payments. The Treasury Bureau reports debt payments rose by 40% to 68.98 billion pesos from the 49 billion a year ago. Month-on-month, debt payments dropped by over 57%. The increase in debt settlements can be largely attributed to the increased interest costs, which surged to 61 billion pesos in May, almost twice the amount paid a year earlier. Year-to-date, the country's total debt payments totaled 1.22 trillion pesos. The Philippine Central Bank may deliver larger-than-expected rate cuts with the possibility of up to 250 basis points worth of reductions until 2025. Now, that projection coming from Japanese investment bank Nomura. Last month, the Monetary Board kept its benchmark rate unchanged for a sixth straight meeting at 6.5%, the highest in over 17 years. Nomura's baseline forecast for the Philippines' policy rate is at 5% at the end of 2025. However, its modified Taylor rule estimates they see key rate slashed to as low as 4%. Now, its baseline projection also anticipates the BSP to deliver a rate cut in October. BSP Governor Eli Remolona Jr. has said the central bank is on track to begin policy easing by August, with the BSP possibly cutting rates by up to 50 basis points this year. The Philippine government is optimistic that with sufficient investments in digital infrastructure, the country will have the third strongest internet connection in Southeast Asia within 4 years. Andrea Taguines reports.
The Philippines is on the path towards having the third strongest internet connectivity in Southeast Asia by 2028. That forecast coming from Philippine ICT Secretary Ivan Uy. Speaking at the Build Better More Infrastructure Forum in New Clark City, Uy pointed out that in the past year alone, the country was able to raise its connectivity score by 14% from 65 points to 74.4 points in the latest ICT Development Index of the United Nations Agency, International Telecommunication Union. He said this puts the Philippines on the 6th or 7th spot out of the 10 ASEAN countries, up from its previous number 9 ranking. This was driven by increased household internet access and mobile broadband subscriptions. But Uy also stressed the need for more investments in the Philippines' ICT infrastructure to be able to stay on this growth trajectory.
If we continue in this trajectory of a 14% increase in our index in the past year, then I'm hoping that by 2028, we could probably be in the top three in ASEAN. That's assuming that we continue to get more funding in order to do this, because our ASEAN neighbors are not sitting back and relaxing. They're also infusing huge amounts of investments in their internet connectivity. So we need to double what they're putting.
Uy also announced that the Philippines' free public internet access program has now provided free Wi-Fi services to more than 13,000 access points, serving 1,400 cities, including over 3,000 geographically disadvantaged areas. He said this has benefited 9.8 million new users. The DICT, however, is looking at possibly regulating its use to prevent it from slowing down.
Alam niyo po, ang free Wi-Fi binibigay rin ng gobyerno sa atin upang magamit natin for online learning, for accessing many of these government services. Hindi ho ito pang social media, pang post ng sumasayaw kayo or downloading movies. So we may start blocking or restricting the free Wi-Fi to access online education sites, telemedicine sites, e-commerce sites, but not the sites that are non-productive.
The agency aims to expand its reach to 125,000 sites by 2028.
The Philippines needs to double its current number of cell towers to meet ICT demands. Internet penetration stands at 73.6% overall. Yet, remote regions in Mindanao lack access, underscoring the need for more targeted efforts.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. recently approved the 16 billion peso Philippine Digital Infrastructure Project, which aims to complete the national fiber backbone of the country and bring high-speed internet connection even in remote areas. It involves the construction of a public broadband infrastructure network to be funded by the World Bank. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
The Ayala-led AC Mobility aims to put up over 100 electric vehicle charging stations by the end of the year. The announcement comes as the company launched its latest EV charging hub in Parañaque. More from Jackie Pascual.
Ayala-led AC Mobility is confident of hitting over 100 electric vehicle or EV charging stations by the end of the year. Its CEO, Jaime Alfonso Zobel de Ayala, led the launch of its newest EV charging hub at a mall in Parañaque. And company officials say this should now be the standard of all EV charging stations in the country.
This is a model for what we can do nationwide. We can ensure that we put in the best spaces in our real estate, that we connect it, we make it reliable, and that over time it's much more affordable than the alternative of fuel as well.
AC Mobility says the charging hub can serve several types of vehicles, including those used for public transportation.
It's one of our first charging sites to offer both AC charging and DC fast charging. With this mix of power capacities, we're able to serve multiple types of vehicles at different speeds, suitable for the charging of private cars, fleet vehicles, and even public transport.
AC Mobility now has 70 EV charging stations, mostly in Metro Manila, and more are expected to open in Bacolod, Iloilo, and other major cities. It has also partnered with EverApp, which will find nearby charging stations and even display the charger availability and compatibility, as well as payment options. The company is hopeful that EV adoption will continue to grow in the Philippines despite challenges like poor infrastructure.
When we recognize the critical need to provide widespread infrastructure, more importantly, in quality locations that are convenient for our customers.
Our urban roads are congested, right? And not all homes can have fast chargers for themselves. Another challenge is that our establishments don't have the same electrical setup, and usually this brings about high cost of infrastructure to implement the stations.
Zobel de Ayala is still confident of the growth potential of the EV sector amid climate change and the high cost of fuel.
In an emerging economy like the Philippines, EVs stand out to be more economical. With EVs, your peso goes further.
AC Mobility is willing to partner with other companies to expand the EV charging stations. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
As the air conditioning system of the Ninoy Aquino International Airport Terminal 3 is set to shut down for 12 hours. Airport authorities say the terminal's cooling system will be turned off from 9 p.m. on Tuesday, July 16, until 9 a.m. on Wednesday to allow the installation of 6 new cooling towers. Around 77,000 passengers or 27,000 passengers on over 100 local and international flights might experience some discomfort due to the interruption. The Manila International Airport Authority says medical teams would be on high alert and ready to respond to any medical emergency. Prices of vegetables expected to decrease this week with the start of the harvest season. The Agriculture Department says vegetable prices in public markets have gone up in the past few weeks due to heavy rains and the El Nino phenomenon, which delayed the beginning of the harvest season in some areas. Aside from erratic weather conditions, the agency also cites the recent oil price hikes for the increase in vegetable prices. A kilo of eggplant has risen by 80 pesos to 180 pesos. Tomatoes now at 180 pesos from last week's 120, while a kilo of carrots have also increased by 40 pesos. A bit of reprieve for motorists as pump prices are heading lower following a four-week streak of hikes. Estimates show kerosene could see the biggest cut, potentially dropping by up to 1 peso and 20 centavos per liter. Diesel prices could also go down by as much as 1 peso and 10 centavos per liter. A liter of gasoline, meanwhile, could decrease by at least 26 or 60 centavos per liter. A progressive House lawmaker slams the planned construction of a 32 billion peso stadium near Clark International Airport. Gabriela Partilist Representative Arlene Brosa says the project is a gross misplacement of priorities amid the ongoing economic crisis and widespread poverty in the country. The Clark International Airport Corporation earlier announced its plan to construct a 35,000-seater arena in Pampanga that can host major international events, including the concert of pop superstar Taylor Swift. The Philippines earlier missed out on the singer's hit worldwide concert, The Eras Tour, allegedly due to the production's exclusivity clause with Singapore. Celebrations for Bastille Day in France get an Olympic twist. The traditional fireworks display again took place around the Eiffel Tower, but this time around a large flock of drones joined the show, creating the shape of the Olympic rings and the athletes in the sky above Paris. Now the Olympic torch has also arrived in the host city for the relay, which will culminate with the lighting of the cauldron during the opening ceremonies.